questions and anything you want to say, well, come on up and say it.
Mary Claire!
Should I not
touch it?
Just get
it
close.
You'll get
electric.
Get a little
taller. Okay, first of all, happy 80th birthday, brother. And we do have you back. It's going to be a fun night. I feel the electricity. Or maybe it's from this mic. I don't know. Anyway, we're going to start the evening off. And thank you for using your indoor voices tonight. Because right now, I mean, later on, you can do whatever you want. But as a present to you, my husband and I, Dan, we have a little musical presentation for you. And I'll just let that speak for itself. But we just love you. I love you. You were my really good boy. But anyway, enjoy your evening. Enjoy each other. Because music is a universal language that makes everybody feel good. And hopefully it all be something nice and nice. Anyway, there you are.
Hey.
Take it away.
Oh, all right.
Thanks, Mary.
Thanks, Mary.
You're welcome.
Let's see if we can get it together here.
Chop, chop.
All right. So anyway, this song here, Mary picked this out for Dan.
Alrighty then. Thank you.
many musical contributions that Dan has given to this community is the Strumbums. The Strumbums have been around for 20 years. They took a break. There's a new version of Strumbums starting week. I think it's Monday week at the Helling Library. The library has asked Dan to run the Strumbums at the library weekly. So this is a big video, and here are some of the incredible Strumbums with a special song for Dan.
Dan has a saying that he always uses with the Strumbums. It's once a Strumbum, always a Strumbum.
I was really surprised because I thought it would have been one of his own.
But anyway, Mary, no. You want to start the roast right away? You want to have Jimmy come up?
Dan and Jim, the two oldest brothers. Jimmy, you want to start off the roast and toast for Dan?
Hello.
I'm going to go lock myself in the bathroom.
Wait. You never could go to the bathroom by yourself until you turned of age. So anyway, you know, this is a pretty good outcome for Dan's 80th year. You know, the first one we did for Dan was about, I don't know, 35 or 40 years ago. We had a fan club coming down. They were going to have a parade and the whole thing. But we had to cancel it because one guy got sick and the other one just couldn't make it. You know, Dan and I we're pretty close together. We, you know, we weren't born the same year, but we were born less than a year apart. His dad, my dad too, had a pretty hard time keeping his pants on. If it wasn't for World War II and the Navy, I might have been sharing another birthday with my sister Kathy. My dad had a hard time, you know, my mother always wore these permanents in her hair and stuff. And high heels, and God, my dad loved that shit. So, anyway, that explains all why we have so many kids in our family. Who is Dan, anyway? Dan, would you raise your hand? I can't. I'm vision impaired. Dan, raise your hand.
Oh, he's
over here. Oh! So, you know, Dan was the smart one in the family. He was the only one that was smart enough to get out of the house when he turned out 18. You know, the rest of us were too dumb. But we learned from Dan. But I think I learned more from Dan than anybody else because everything Dan was out doing, my mother accused me of doing, and I got in trouble for doing the stuff he was getting away with. But I wasn't as smart as Dan, you know? And he proved that to me a few times. We would take these little runs. He would tell me that, even today, he was telling me about remembering stuff that, like, riding on a bicycle with a little bit of chain-powered and stuff. And one of them would sit on the seat, and one would stand on the lug nuts on the back of the back wheel while we go down Dead Man's Hill, about a block away from our house. Guess who was on the lug nuts? You know, he was a lot brainier than me.
But he had
Oh, yeah. Yeah. She was on the handlebars one time.
Yeah.
But we didn't care. We didn't care about her either. I should be very careful here because she might be up here talking. I have no idea what's going on there. So, but anyway, I am so glad to really see everybody here in Dan's honor. He's the first one in our family to reach the illustrious age of 80. And nobody's known him, I'm guessing, in this room longer than I have, because we're less than a year apart. And I've seen everything he's done. I've seen his ass before anybody in here has. And I'm sure a lot of you have probably seen it, but never the way I have. So, you know, he asked me the other day, he says, you know, do you remember how to spell from grammar school? And I said, yeah. And he said, well, how do you spell butt cheeks? Is it one word or is there a split in there? And I didn't quite know how to answer, so I refer all those kind of questions to my brother Timmy. He's the stupidest of all because he got me up here talking to you. Happy birthday, Dan.
You know, Jimmy, that was so freaking good. You know, I'm telling you what, I really admire my family, my sibs. And Dan, I am so proud to be part of this family and to be the pivoting point or the middle or whatever. But I have to say, before I send somebody else up, Mr. Sauer, yes, I want Pat Sauer up here, but also before that, Mr. Tony Villona, because these are really close friends of my brother Dan, and I mean tight, this is really tight, and you know, this is supposed to be a roast, we don't want this a roast or toast. Well, if it's Halloween, it's a little gross. But I was thinking about this. It was really hard for me to come up with stuff to roast you about because I always looked up to you, mainly because you were taller. But but really, seriously though, let's be serious for a moment. Okay, that's what I'm gonna say. Anyway, I just want to say that I seriously always looked up to him, and when I had something to share with him, he always made me feel really good about what it was I was sharing, and made me feel better about myself. And he just, you know, you couldn't have a better, bigger brother other than Jimbo. I got great siblings, older and younger, and I can't be more proud of all of you kids. And don't make me start crying because it really, you know, I don't really cry. Anyway, okay, enough about me talking about me. Let's talk, have you talk about me. No, okay. But Mr. Villano, would you like to come up and say something? Or am I putting you on the spot?
Put him on the spot.
You know what? Thank you. This is a good one.
Well, except for some of Dan's brothers and sisters, I'm pretty sure I've known him the longest. And not all of his brothers and sisters. I've known some of Dan before some of his brothers and sisters knew him. We go way back. We did a lot of crazy stuff together. Oh man, I'm not even gonna go through that. One of the things I was thinking last night was all the music that we had. And, you know, Dan and I spent time together doing stuff when we were in high school. I went to college and came back with a guitar. And then Dan started playing. And I kind of think that was kind of the response for, you know, what we got last night and what Dan's sort of career is. I'm not very good at roasting, obviously, but I just really enjoy everybody being here. It's just awesome. And thanks, Dan, for being my friend for so long.
What a great school. How early?
Pardon?
How early were you with Dan in grade school?
Fourth grade. Yeah, so yeah, we met in fourth grade. The school just started. That was the first year that the school worked. We never had a senior classman until we went to college. So we were always the oldest kids on the block before the rest of the school. All right, really fun. Okay.
You know, one time in the early 80s, Jonathan Richmond was playing in Ireland and Dan said, hey, we're going to go over to Ireland and go see Jonathan. So, sure enough, we got on a jet and went over there. And I said, Dan, well, where are we staying? And he said, I don't know. We hitchhiked everywhere, had no car, had no transportation. I heard I had a hell of a good time. But Dan was loved in every pub he went into. And I got all the free beers, so he was playing, and I got all the free drinks. So. But that was a great memory, Dan. I'll never forget that one. And yes, it did cure. I don't see Pat Sauer. Is he here?
Over there.
Oh, Pat. Pat is the brother I didn't realize wasn't my brother until I was probably 12 or 13. He was always around.
Well, I'm accustomed as I am. Can you hear me? Yes. I think there's a thin line between, I guess, August or early September of 1961, when Dan and I were in alphabetical order in the line of Loyola University orientation, and first started the conversation, which you guys told many people goes on to this day. And the through line is music flavored with tolerance. And we have given each other a lot of space to be the better and the worse that we are. And I was just thinking of our career music-wise was Dan had a a real feel and a love for the big band era and Tin Pan Alley, and that was the music that I heard on the radio when I was in my high chair. And so we had something in common around that. And he liked to play it, and I had my $15 Tijuana guitar. I would play it in the stairwell at the dormitory because it got great reverb and didn't have to plug anything in. And Dan, of course, had ukuleles, and he was showing me things that I were unexpected and that actually worked out. But fast forward from the 60s, by 1973, I was back from having been in the Navy, active duty in the Philippines, and we had gotten together. I was up in Sacramento working for a news service, and I was covering Ronald Reagan as the governor of the state. And I was one of the two ponytail reporters in the crowd at that time. And Dan came up to visit because for some reason he didn't want to be in Poway anymore. I think it had to do with a job and a school board and a marriage. And so we got together and we were playing in the local bars. And we played a lot of places. We played in El Paso right off the freeway. We were hitchhiking our way to Mardi Gras. And just went to the first bar off of the first ride that let us out. And got lined up right away. I had my Dobro, he had his Uke, and we played and we got lined up with more beers than we could drink. Rode all the way across to New Orleans, mostly in the back of the trucks, and played Mardi Gras until a cop took a billy club and smashed the head on Dan's ukulele. And we were on a tight budget at the time. I remember that two of the strings on my guitar had broken and I had square knots in it. So. Forward from that, I have other memories of a place that we played. I don't know if it was close to Sacramento, a little bit out of town. It was a Chinese restaurant, and the highlight of the show was when Dan farted in the mic. And I thought, it's loose. And subsequently, over the decades, every time we get together, the first thing that happens is the guitars and the ukes come out. He's gifted me at least three that I know of, ukuleles. And I'm still on Ancient Sweet, but I sure like it. The tolerance part is one that makes it worthwhile to have a friend that you are so deeply connected to, and obviously to all of the Scanlon siblings. I was telling Tommy yesterday, when JFK got assassinated, it was a Friday afternoon, it shut down school, we were resident students and we were heading home for the weekend. And the first stop was at Dan's house. I was in the same carpool that was taking me back to Lakewood, and he's closer to the university. So we got out of the car, and the first coverage of the assassination that I saw was on the Scanlon television set in Linwood. And, did I say Linwood? Lawndale. I am so. Wow.
I was born with
Linwood. Oh, well. I worked there too.
And it's because it was St. Michael's, and if you had six kids, your sixth kid was free.
BOGO, buy one, get one. Yeah, anyway, yeah, in Lawndale. So sorry. And, so it was a memory that I shared with Tom yesterday. In any case, over the years, the songs that we wrote were absolutely diaries of what we were going through, and certainly Dan wrote a lot more of them than I did, and he kept better track of them too. And I appreciate that he is very much a historian of his ups and downs through music. And a guy I love, you know, can't say anything else about that. I have one stanza of a limerick that I was going to write in extended stanzas, but I think I'm going to need my glasses to actually read. You got readers? Yeah, very much.
What are they,
200?
Yeah, something like that.
It's mine or 350.
I don't know. You're older than me, but you look better than me. So
yeah, I can start a fire. Okay, simple. We're all here to celebrate Dan, a most multi-talented man. Among the best fixers with jewels or elixirs, he's won himself many a fan.
I'm the baby and I don't sit down very easily, but I don't know, I want to show a hand. Who wants Dan in a chair up here so we can see his reaction? Woo! Sorry, Dan.
Can we hook it up to some electrodes?
I get to tell my big brother what to do. Get your banana up here so we can see how you react. My head's getting tired of craning. Oh, thank you.
There's no chair.
I'll get you one.
Here.
Little sister dessert. Sorry, I can't take it. My head's going to be... I thought you had a chair. Here, get my chair. Right here.
Yes, Lord.
It's all right. I always had to sit on the hump.
Where's the toilet paper?
I'll get the battery in the
table. All right. Thank you. Good job. He's always been the one I've gone to when something was broken or hurt. And it is so wonderful to be here to celebrate his 80th year on this earth. My mom and dad are so proud of him. And so's grandma and grandpa. I love you, Dan.
Hello. Okay, how about Brother Billy, two musicians.
Hi, I just flew from New York, where my arm's tired. That joke goes as far back as my hairline, I'm sorry. Take my wife, for example. Go ahead, take it. See, that's where I got my humor, was Danny here, see? But, I played guitar earlier, but if it wasn't for Danny, I never would have played guitar at all. He showed me, what was it, Pipeline, when I was probably 10 years old. I was still in diapers, actually, when I was listening to him play, him and Pat. And big influence. So, I love you, brother.
Anyway, but yeah, Dan introduced me. You don't know how many people you have influenced. I didn't even know I was being influenced. I didn't like to be influenced by anybody because I thought I was independent. Here I was influenced by you. But I was influenced by the best. Anyway, so I go upstairs to our room and I'm picking out songs. And, because Danny used to do that, and I thought, well, heck, I can do that. So I started doing ding, 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 ding.
Oh, yeah.
And I, yeah.
Winchester.
Yeah, right. Winchester.
That's right.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And then Pipeline, hell, I, excuse me, heck. So then I got comfortable with that, and then I introduced it to you, and you took the ball. You took the ball and ran with it. And you don't realize how important you are. And how important you are to love with you. You know what, John? You are a rock. An absolute. I admire you. You have great humor. You're so smart. Oh, he's got some background music. But yesterday, you're my hero. Anyway, you guys are a great match, and we're all happy to be part of it. And anyway, anybody else want to come up and say a little something? Okay, then. I think you what? Oh!
I'm Leona Dance. I'm Dan and Nancy's oldest twin daughter.
I'm Summer Song, the younger one.
And I kind of thought that the roast was only going to be one person making fun of my dad the whole time. I kind of thought that the roast... Oh, I need to be closer? Thank you.
Okay.
But then we're separated.
Joan, because that's his wife,
and he loves her very much, and he loves me very much. And that's all.
Got to be one of my best friends ever.
Say who you are. Let them know that you're his ex-wife.
Oh. That's true. Yeah, I'm his ex-wife, Nancy. And we had two beautiful daughters that really have got us both through a lot of times, you know, hard times. But I just want to say Dan is unique, so creative, and it's like he can practically do anything. And when it comes to helping people, he's always willing to help people. And he's just got a wicked sense of humor. And I don't know, he's quite the ukulele player right here. Anyway, we love Dan so much. And we're very thankful to have him in our lives, like all of you are.
And I first met Dan through his lovely, beautiful, and talented wife, Joan, back in the day, probably in the 80s, and have been, luckily, been the babysitter of this fabulous Paradise property. And his lovely dog, Murphy. Murphy and my son, Luca, they are buddies. And Luca has also had the luck of being on the ranch when I went somewhere else. And I was lucky to take care of their wonderful, you can see the love in their property. It's all surrounding it. It's beauty in every way, generosity. Dan's so generous. Even let me sing with him. And sing loud and sing what I wanted. And I will always really appreciate you. And I believe too that we both have a love of the islands, Hawaiian islands. And every time that I hear the ukulele, I remember the beach, the waves, the people, the wonderful, wonderful culture. And also, just the folk history, he's a real genius in the history of the ukulele, and I've learned so much from you about the ukulele, and your generosity in teaching everybody, and everybody's good, no matter. Everybody's good, everybody's great, so everybody, let's have a little ukulele palooza.
Star Trek, Tina's husband, and a woman.
Brother-in-law.
There you go.
So I felt kind of left out because, you know, you had Jim come up and say he's the first one to see Dan naked, and then Tony Bonanno said he's his oldest friend, he's known him longer than everyone else. Well, I thought, well, I have something unique that I'm the only one that has this, and I'm Dan's first and only boss.
You're fired!
So I heard this was a roast, so I wrote a little bit of roasty stuff. It's all nice. It's all nice. I was like, how can you roast Dan Scanlon? I don't even know how, but I thought of a couple things. So I'm going to just share them with you now. My name is Lee. I lived with Dan and Joan for a few years when my family and I first moved here. And they kind of put me up on their property. And so we got our feet on the ground. And we eventually bought a house, and we love Grass Valley very much. And thank you guys so much for that. So now on to the roast part here. We all know how much Dan loves presidents, people in power, the government, right? Matter of fact, something you may not know is Dan loves politics so much, he once ran for governor. And some of the people still know him as the gov out here to this very day, so you may not have known that, all right? Another thing I've come to love about Dan is that he's a great storyteller. And in fact, his stories are so great, He'll tell them to you 1, 2, 3, 5, 10. I mean, who's counting, you know? Well, I do love dance stories. One of my favorites is when they went up to the giant redwood, got all the way up there. Dan played a song with Julia Butterfly, and Joan interviewed her. I think that's so cool. And another one I love is when Dan was a teacher, standing up for what he believed was right and teaching the children morality. And he believed in his conviction so much that he spoke them even though he could lose his job over speaking them. And spoiler alert, he did lose that job over speaking them. Go, Dan. And y'all might remember a great folk singer by the name of Utah Phillips.
Yeah.
All right. Well, he was a big fan of Mr. Dan Scanlon, a.k.a. Cool Handy. And Dan let me know that Utah once told Dan that he, Dan, had more talent in his little pinky than in the whole rest of his body. Utah Phillips. I mean, and finally, everyone who knows Dan knows that he loves instruments, in particular the ukulele. And in fact, he's made a guitar and a uke in the same instrument. Calls it a uke-tar or a guitar-lele, I think. Uke-tar, right. And then he put 3 different instruments into 1 guitar body he made out of just 1 piece of wood. And it's got the whole history of the ukulele in 1 piece of wood. Very cool. I saw it for the first time yesterday. It's awesome. Well, next I heard he was going to make a combination of a drum set, guitar, bass, piano, and a ukulele out of 1 piece of wood. Dan Scanlon. In all honesty, my family are extremely grateful for Dan and Joan's great hospitality and kindness. And when we moved here, they welcomed us with open arms and let us stay on their land while we got established and got our house. And thank you both so much for that. That was great. And thanks to Trevor for introducing us to Dan and Joan. And Dan also inspired me to play the ukulele, and I've since fallen in love with that. So thanks so much for being amazing people, guys. That's all I have. Okay.
The youngest one of our siblings, Tina. You want to come up? Yeah. There are the bookends. All the rest of us just fit in between Dan and Tina.
He's 11 years older than me, so you know, he was out of the house by the time I was 9 years old. Anyway, so I know so much about Dan because of Kathy. Kathy and I live a mile away from each other, and we're soul brother and sister. We're medicine for each other. Dan's 50th birthday Kathy was going through some stuff. I didn't know what to do, so I woke up Dan, because he was medicine. And then a couple weeks ago, Kathy went through another very trying time. She called me over, and I didn't feel free to leave her until Dan called out of the blue. He didn't know what was going on. He was informed. And anyway, he was medicine for my medicine maker. And the other thing, I was a teenager, and Dan told me to live an adventurous life. He said, nobody will ever let you starve. And I believed it and took it to life. I made some stupid decisions. But now that I'm in my 60s, I'm living a hell of an adventurous life, and nobody's letting me start.
Scanlons, please raise your hands. Come on, there's more of you. Well, there were 60 of them at our house yesterday. Some of them, I guess, didn't make it out of bed today, but you've heard some of the ones that have. This is the most amazing family to be part of. And to have this family with the name of Scanlon in the middle of this other family that is a wonderful group of people that I have gotten to know in the years that I've been here. And I just hope I can keep talking without starting crying. I'm so touched by the love that I feel with so many of you, and what a beautiful group this is. And so much of it, well, all of it has to do with this guy. And this guy, as you well know, is full of creativity, intelligence, impatience, sometimes patience, an attitude, and it's either his way or the highway, right? Do we know this? One of the things that Dan has always been for me is living his truth every minute and honoring himself in that way every minute of the day. As irrational and unpredictable as he can be, he is also solidly there. You may not agree with where there is, because you know that some of those ideas, especially the political ones, are pretty far out there. But he is there, and you know he is there, and I know that he has been there for me for many 35 years. Yeah. And, you know, to have someone like that is just amazing and wonderful and beautiful. But not easy. Not easy. No stories. Sorry, I'm not going there. So, you all are much funnier than I am in public. So 35 years of appreciating, loving, and growing with this man has been wonderful, and I'm happy to share that love with you all. Thanks.
Thank you. say. There's nothing to say. Let's play some music. Thanks for being here. Thanks for all the comments and love and showing up and doing something on a Sunday besides watching football. Normally I'm not at a loss for words. Part of the reason is because when I think of something to say and I go to say it, I can't remember it. That happens all the time. People I've known for 50 years, I walked up to them, ha! Who are you again? I'm hoping we would have a community jam, just play some music together, fish around a little bit to see what's there. Okay, so anybody wants to come up here and play a little bit and lead everyone else, you can beat on the table, make drums. If you see an instrument you want to play, pick it up and play it. We will.